In this After Effects tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create smooth title animations using text animators. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. Text animators are a powerful tool to create unique titles quickly with just a few keyframes. Three examples coming right up. Let's get going with the first one. As always, we create a new comp, animation 1, 96 frames long. We grab the title tool and add some text. I use Bio Sans, the font is available on Adobe Fonts. Text style light, size 150 pixels. Let's make it all caps and center the text. And center the text layer using the alignment tool. We open the text layer and in this drop-down menu here, we add a position animator. We open the range selector property and set the endpoint to 0. Add a keyframe for the start point. In advanced, we set shape to ramp up. Then we set the Y position of the animator to 150. Next, we click on the add menu next to the animator to add another property, opacity. We set it to 0 and add keyframes for the position and opacity. Alright. At 10 frames, we set the start value to 100. At 24 frames, we set the position to 0 to bring the text up completely. And the opacity to 100%. Kind of smooth, but not really. That's when the graph editor comes into play. We select all keyframes, open it, make sure snap is activated and edit speed graph is selected. Then we adjust the speed curves until we think it's smooth enough. The start point. Simple and clean title animations require a lot of attention to detail. Better already. Next, the opacity and the position. Let's see. Not there yet. With little changes to the speed curves, you can completely change the character of the animation. That's awesome. Next, we grab the rectangle tool and add a mask around the text. That's it. We easily could add another line by duplicating the layer. Changing the text. Oops. Maybe even the text style. Bold. Awesome. The second one. We add a new comp, same settings as before. Then let's add two text layers with each one word. The first one, opposite. We duplicate the text layer and replace the text. Directions. Alright, we position them next to each other. For some contrast, let's use different text styles. Bold and light, for example. And let's align them horizontally. Then we use the rectangle tool to add two masks, surrounding the words. And they meet here in the center, between the two words. They don't overlap though. Let's add a position animator to the left word. We set the X position to 700, which moves the text to the right. Then we open the range selector and set an end keyframe. We go to 24 frames and set it to 0. Okay. We go to advanced and set based on two words. Better. We open the graph editor and slow down the end of the animation. Smoother. Alright. Next, we open the add menu next to the animator and add an opacity property and set it to 0, which fades the word in. Then we add a tracking property and set the tracking amount to 50, which adds another subtle layer of detail. And we've set only two keyframes. Now we repeat that for the other word, but we kind of mirror the animation. We add a position animator, set it to based on words again, and set the X position to around minus 800 this time. Move the word to the left. In range selector, we add an end keyframe and set it to 0 at 24 frames. We add the opacity property, set it to 0. And the tracking property. Set the amount to 50. And again, we use the graph editor to slow down the end of the animation. That's it. Clean and very smooth. Nevertheless, unique. Let's take a quick moment to look at the 750 plus Motion Graphics Advanced Pack. It comes with its own extension so you can preview all elements directly in After Effects. From shape elements to title animations, lower thirds, animated icons, and so much more. let's apply this big title to our comp with just one click. Let's go into the comp and change the text to smooth animation. Adjust the overall size in the control layer. How about combining it with an animated background? Again, we go into the comp, adjust the colors in the control layer. Very quick, very simple. Make sure to check out the link in the description below. This pack will save you a ton of time. You'll come up with high quality animations almost instantly, which is insane. Link is in the description. All right, time for the third example. We add some text again. Distorted text, a light text style this time. We center it again using the alignment tool. Then we open the text layer and add an opacity animator. We add a keyframe at the beginning and set the opacity to 0. Then we add a tracking amount property and set the amount to something crazy like 550 or so. And set a keyframe. We go to 44 frames and set the tracking amount to 0. The opacity to 100. We select all keyframes, open the graph editor to adjust the speed curves. Let's slow down the end of the animations quite a bit. I think that's great. Now that would be a nice animation, but let's take it one step further. We duplicate the layer 5 times. Then we go to View and click Show Grid and Snap to Grid. Next, we grab the Rectangle tool and add a mask. Starting at the top. Height is 1 square. The layer below, we copy the mask and paste it to the layer. And move the mask 1 row lower. It should snap. And so on. Then we offset the layers by a few frames. Alright. Let's get rid of the grid. How about we move the X positions by a few pixels? And you could even change the text style for some of the rows. Awesome! I hope these examples inspired you somehow. Check out the Motion Graphics Advanced Pack and get your freebie pack, of course. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell, because you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, guys!